Self-driving vehicles, what was once thought of as futuristic fantasy, is now a reality. Hi, I'm Cheryl Angelelli, a contributor for New Mobility magazine, and today I'm headed to Ann Arbor, Michigan, the headquarters of May Mobility, to ride in the first wheelchair-accessible autonomous vehicle to be on the road today. And I'm taking you along for the ride. The first step is reserving our free on-demand ride by going to May Mobility's mobile app. 6 minutes later, my wheelchair-accessible autonomous vehicle, otherwise known as an AV, arrives on time, but not exactly driverless.
Hey, Cheryl.
Every vehicle in this phase of May Mobility's launch is currently staffed by an autonomous vehicle operator. My operator assisted me getting into the vehicle and strapping my wheelchair and me in place. The operators also sit in the driver's seat, and although they are not driving, they can take over if there is a safety issue.
If somebody is parked here in the bike lane, it'll move over.
It will know to switch lanes, okay.
Correct.
Each accessible AV can accommodate two ambulatory riders and one rider using a wheelchair. As we pull out into traffic, it's amazing to see how the car understands and reacts to real-world situations, like stopping for pedestrians, traffic lights,
stop line,
and even navigating construction zones.
So did it recognize the code?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Thanks to May Mobility's AV technology, the vehicle imagines thousands of real-world driving scenarios every second. It looks at the most likely scenarios and the high-risk scenarios, and in milliseconds, it makes the decision what to do.
So this was my first time in an AV, and I have to say the whole process was pretty easy. The ride was very smooth and comfortable. And I would definitely do this again if I didn't have access to a vehicle. So what about you? Are AVs the future of accessible transportation for people with disabilities? And is it something you would try? Leave us a comment and let us know.